Oh, thank you. I was so stoned I couldn't keep them in my mouth.
I know.
You must understand, because you're a dog, because I'm bigger than you, and because I asked you to bring me the slippers, and because that's the way things are, you can be punished to the full extent of German law for non-compliance with my request. Do I make myself clear to you, boy?
She turned to the man and said, "Hey, boy,
little man, who immediately turned away from him like that and dashed out and bought a pair of scissors and used the change to pick up a pair of zircon-encrusted tweezers and came back and lusted on the aforementioned poodle, as I will now demonstrate. She cleaned up his act right around here in the region of the snout, also in the thorax, pruned him thoroughly about the medulla, gradually working her way down to the monocle. Eventually, she got around to the final stages of modification of the area that we here in the fatherland today know to be Dusseldorf. Then she turned her right side up.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
He would firmly grasp the mysterious Princeton. Now you gotta understand, this is not the real thing. This particular piece of equipment doesn't look too good because it's been all over the fatherland and has had seen quite a bit of use. So you have to use your imagination. We're too poor to afford a real nozzle on the end of this one. That one's not the right kind, it was this kind. And then, let's use that for John. And then, he would go into the doo-doo room and fill up the bag.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mr. Midget with a bucket and a mop where the blood goes down the drain. Oh.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
behind you.